Hey guys, my name is Bharat and I'm the creator of Bharat in Germany. This is the episode 8, season 2 of A Day in Life of a Student in Germany, where we show you lifestyles of students studying in different German universities. This season is brought to you in collaboration with Study in Germany, Land of Ideas, a campaign conducted by DAAD, the German Academic Exchange Service. In this episode, we have Diego from Mexico with us, who is studying at Fulda. Let's take a look.
My name is Diego Leñero. I come from Mexico and I have been studying in Germany for around 2 years now. I study digital media at the University of Fulda, which is in Fulda, of course. Fulda, if you don't know about it, it's a small city in Hessen. I mean, it's not so small, but you couldn't compare it to Frankfurt, Berlin, Hamburg, something like that. And my life looks kind of different right now because of the pandemic and all that, but I still think it could be very interesting for someone who's interested in studying in Germany. So if that's something for you, I'm very happy if you join me now. Let's get this video started. Welcome to Day in My Life. As you can see, it is dark outside. That's because it's 10 p.m. It's a little late. And if you're wondering, why are you starting your Day in My Life video at night? That's because, in my opinion, a good day, a normal day in my life, actually starts the night before, because that's when you get the time to plan what you're gonna do, to leave stuff ready, and to just get like mentally and physically prepared for what you're gonna do the next day. So I'm gonna show you the 3 things I do every night before my day actually starts. Let's see them. So the first thing I do is also the most important one. I get my 2 monitors here, and in one of the screens I put all the goals I have set for this week, and on the other one I have the schedule for the next day. So what I'm doing basically is looking at the goals, and I just try to see how I can be working on those goals the more hours, like the most possible hours of the day. I don't always plan every single hour of the day because it kind of stresses me out, but when it's like finals, when I have a lot of work, I do plan like every single hour. So this is the most important thing I do before I go to sleep. Besides planning what I'm gonna do, I also leave ready some stuff that I'm gonna use the next day. For example, every time before the gym, I have a small snack, I have some green tea, and also I do my reading in the morning. So I just leave this by my desk, so it's already here waiting for me as soon as I wake up and I can do it. I also leave the clothes ready that I'm gonna use the next day, and I also try to clean my room, do the dishes, like just leave it in an environment that is just easy to get things done. Like, you leave the environment to get the stuff done that you want to get done. The second thing I do is, when you are on your daily life, you often encounter some words or some concepts, some topics that you know nothing about. So what I do is I give myself 30 minutes to look any of those things up. Like, I just have 30 minutes that I have to open an empty page, open my notebook, and just research something and write about it. And that was like 6 months ago. And from that day, I've been doing it every single day. I would show you my notes. I kind of research all type of stuff. So the gym is gonna open in 10 minutes. It's not so cold today, but the weather isn't so nice. That was it for the workout, and we're back home. It's just like 10 minutes walking, 8 minutes or 7 with the skateboard. This whole place is the garden, and this is the Schloss. As you can see, it's beautiful, and it's a public place. Anybody can just come here for a run, even like ride a horse. You can see someone riding a horse. I've never seen that here, but it's the first time. Awesome. And it's just a really nice place. A lot of people come here to just hang out, and it's just amazing. And I'm gonna show you the cathedral that is behind this wall. So we were just over there at the Schlossgarten, and right next to it is the Fulda Dome, the Fulda Cathedral. It's a beautiful building. You look around and there are so many beautiful buildings all over in Fulda. Like, it's just impressive, and the whole city looks like it. Maybe it's a small city, maybe there's not so much things going on, but it is perfectly pretty for a small city, and there is enough things happening for you to do. I do love to come here every once in a while to meditate, just sit down and do nothing for 10 minutes and just breathe. So after the meditation, I'm just starving because it's kind of a time where I'm not doing anything, and it's right after the workout, so I just start getting hungry. So now it's time for breakfast. So breakfast is done. Not gonna lie, I have seen better looking breakfasts out there. If you're trying to lose weight, I would not recommend this type of breakfast. It's definitely a lot of calories, a lot of fat, but also a lot of protein. So if you're trying to gain weight, it's a good idea. If you're trying to lose weight, not a good idea. And this right here is my room. I'm gonna show you what I have, what I use, and yeah. As you can see, it's not huge, although it kind of looks big on the recording, I'm not gonna lie, but it's just perfect in my opinion. I wouldn't need more space than this. I mean, it's just perfect. I've got, I did something kind of weird to optimize my space. I had two tables, one and two, and this one used to be like a normal table somewhere. And I came to the realization that I was just using it to put stuff. Like I have my studying stuff, like I have a basket of snacks, I have like my stabilizer. And I wasn't really using the table. Like I use this one, like to write stuff, to use a computer. Like I'm not actually using it. I was just putting stuff on top of it. So I was like, what if I put it on top of the other table? That's what I did. And now you've got like a kind of like a cozy working space in here with even a roof. Also, when I have like friends staying over at my place, I actually have like two Matratzen, that's in German. And I can put one like on the floor and the other one stays here. And then I have space for like more than only one person because the bed is pretty small. As you can see, Marceline just chilling there. And then we got the window. Which, to be honest, if you open both of them like this, like it's a pretty big window and you can get a bunch of light and a bunch of fresh air. And I actually really like my view, especially like, look at this. Even if it's rainy, I think it's a beautiful view. The only thing that is kind of annoying is the church, which rings the bell literally every 30 minutes. Of every single day for no reason. So yeah, that is, but the solution is to just close the window, so it's not a problem. This is where I keep all of my clothes. This is the door. I have another thing here to store like a bunch of stuff. I have like shoes, electronics, random stuff like 3D sunglasses for the cinema, like my cologne, desinfectionsmittel. I got a microwave, which is so useful. I never thought it would be so useful until I started living alone. And it's just awesome because I often cook like a lot of food. For example, this is rice that I cooked like 2 days ago. And I have some vegetables and like I just put them in a plate, microwave, and then I have a quick meal that I cook myself, but I always cook a little more than I need, so it lasts for a couple of days. And talking about cooking, this is the kitchen. I mean, it looks small, but it's basically everything you need. And the fridge, as you can see, is not huge, but it's more than enough the space I need. I even got a freezer, and yeah, that's basically it. I don't have a dishwasher, but I never use dishwashers anyways. I always wash everything by hand, so that's not a problem. And then I've got entertainment stuff like my TV and my Nintendo. And I like the position I put the TV because you can use it if you are like on the bed or if you have more people over. Like you can put something on the bed so a bunch of people can sit on the bed. Some people can sit on chairs, and you've got the like the screen on a good position for that. Then this is the bathroom. Everything in this apartment is exactly what you need, no more, no less. And toilet and another window with the same beautiful view. And that's basically it. So this would be the time that I normally go to my online classes, or the time that I just start studying, doing some uni work and all that type of things. But since I'm on vacation right now, that means I have a little more free time to work on my personal projects. I'm developing an app with my best friends. So if I don't have to study, I can use all that time to work on those projects, which I have a lot of fun working on them. So it's basically like, it doesn't feel like work. It feels like free time, if you can call it free time. It feels like playing something. So yeah, it's definitely nice to have some break from university. But normally this would be the time, like after I go to the gym, shower, breakfast, then it would be the time to start doing all the university stuff. And I hope what I'm gonna tell you can be useful to you in any way. So the first thing I want to talk to you about that really, really makes my life better, and it actually started when I came here to Germany, I think maybe like 6 months after I arrived and started studying. I just started planning every single day. Before going to sleep at night, just writing down in any app, you can find a million apps or websites where you can do your checklist or whatever. But like, I found one in which I can just put the time and what I'm gonna do. And I started doing that. And once I started, I just never stopped. That was like 1.5 years ago. And I just kept doing it every single day. I got kind of obsessed. It got to a point now in which I just like, I plan every single hour. Like, you just go hour by hour what I'm doing. For the second thing I wanna tell you, when I started studying here, I was just doing what I had to do. I was just doing my homework, studying for the exams, but I wasn't asking questions in class. I wasn't trying to participate in anything extra from the university. I wasn't trying to join any groups. I wasn't going to any sports club or something. I wasn't doing any like any type of art. I wasn't meeting new people. So the second tip I wanted to give you is to say yes to everything. And I know how that sounds. Of course you're not gonna say yes to everything. You cannot say yes if someone is offering something that could potentially harm you or your friends or your family. You are not gonna say yes to something that could ruin your life. The fact that you're a student gives you the right to travel all around Hessen. At least that's the case here at the Hochschule Fulda. I mean, I just have to show my student card and I can travel wherever I want. I can get into a train and just travel for free all the way in Hessen. You get so many luxuries for being a student. You get discounts. You get like invited to events. You get like so much stuff. And the first months I was in Germany, I was not using any of those. I was close, like close to people, close to everything. And then I started just like saying yes and joining a sports club, like joining, I don't know, kickboxing practice. Like, that's some stuff I did. There is so much to do and so many opportunities, and you just have to go and take them. So the third and last tip I could tell you, it's something obvious, it's something everybody's gonna tell you, and it's organize your finances. And when I arrived here, everybody was telling me the same, but I had no idea how to do it. I'm gonna try to give you something practical you can do. I made a form in which you just have to say a category, grocery shopping, video games, party, rent, insurance, and then how much money. You write it down and then you press send, and it gets automatically put into a sheets table. And then in that sheets table, you can see all like the date, when did you spend that much, how much, and what category. At the end of the month, you're going to be able to build like a pie graph in which you can see how much percentage of your money is going where. And then you can adjust your spending habits depending on how much you're spending. Maybe you could be spending a little less on this. And just being aware of how much you're spending on each thing can really help you get organized and like make good use of your money. And talking about money, one very good thing you can do to at least get started in your studies in Germany is try to apply for one of the scholarships of the DAAD. I mean, they have really good deals for students, and you should at least try to see what they got and then apply for some of them. Maybe you get one, and that would really be a huge help. So I hope any of these tips could be useful for you in any way, and I want to say goodbye. Thank you for watching all the way this video, and I will leave you with my friend Marat. See you later.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Let us know about your favorite parts in the comment section below. If you want to get featured in the series, write us an email at bharat@bharatingermany.com and we'll get back to you. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.